In this video, we will explore the use of secondary dominant chords in major keys. Secondary dominants will be the first chords that we study that still function within a key but provide chromaticism. Chromatic notes are common in tonal music. For example, it is possible to have a composition in the key of C major, using the white keys on the piano as its main notes, that uses the five black keys as well, but functioning completely in the key of C major. Let's define the term secondary dominant. The word dominant refers to the five chord in the major or minor key. The role of a dominant chord is to pull back to the one chord, also known as the tonic chord, and make it feel like it is the home chord of the key. The word secondary refers to a dominant chord that is not five in the key. Five is also known as the primary dominant. Therefore, a secondary dominant chord is a five that leads to a chord other than one in a major or minor key. Here we have the diatonic triads in the key of C major. The chords are named as follows, and they receive the following Roman numeral analysis. We will notate the dominant chords that lead to each of these diatonic triads. Let's first notate the primary dominant chord. As a triad, this will be G major, but it could also include the addition of the minor seventh, making it a dominant seventh chord. Since the primary dominant can be a triad or a seventh chord, I will put the seventh in parentheses. Any major or minor chord in a key can be preceded by a secondary dominant that makes that chord temporarily feel like one or the tonic chord. The term for this is tonicize. A secondary dominant tonicizes a chord other than one. To find the secondary dominant of D minor, we find the 5 chord in the key of D, which is always a perfect fifth above. Therefore, the 5 chord in D minor is A or A7. We analyze this chord as 5 or 5-7 of 2. Notice that the A chord has a chromatic note, the C sharp. Since secondary dominants are chromatic chords, we expect one or more accidental. The C sharp is a half step below D and serves as the leading tone to the D note, helping the D minor chord temporarily feel like one. We expect the 5-7 of 2 to lead to 2. Next, we will find 5 or 5-7 of 3. We find the 5 chord in E, which is the interval of a fifth above E. This is B or B7. And the notes are B, D sharp, and F sharp for the triad, with A added for the seventh. Next, we will find 5 or 5-7 of 4. We find the 5 chord in F, which is an interval of a fifth above F. Here, the triad will be C. C, E, G. Since C is simply the one chord in the key of C, it will not function as a secondary dominant. The addition of the seventh, B flat, will make it a dominant seventh chord that will pull to 4 as a secondary dominant. In this case, the triad does not work as a secondary dominant. It must be 5-7 of 4. Next, we will find 5 or 5-7 of 5. We find the 5 chord in G, which is an interval of a fifth above G. This is D or D7. And the notes are D, F sharp, and A for the triad, with C added for the seventh. Next, we will find 5 or 5-7 of 6. We find the 5 chord in A, which is an interval of a fifth above A. This is E or E7, and the notes are E, G sharp, and B for the triad, with D added for the seventh. Since 7 diminished is a diminished triad, it will not feel like 1 in a major or minor key. Therefore, there is no 5 or 5-7 of 7 diminished. These Roman numerals will transfer to any major key. A secondary dominant chord is always found a perfect fifth above its chord of resolution. Here are the secondary dominant chords and their chords of resolution in the key of A. Notice that, with the exception of 5, 7, and 4, each of these chords could be a triad or a seventh chord. Here are the secondary dominant chords in the key of E flat major. Let's summarize. The 5 or 5-7 chord in a major or minor key is known as the primary dominant. A secondary dominant chord is a dominant triad or dominant seventh chord that leads to a chord other than 1. A secondary dominant is the 5 or 5-7 chord of the chord of resolution and can be found a perfect fifth above its chord of resolution. In a major key, each secondary dominant can be a triad or dominant seventh chord. The only exception is 5-7-4, which must be a seventh chord.